right. I remember probably about the first time I really had any experience with cross was in about 1989, and my sister had moved up from Adelaide. I'd only just been here for about 3 months, and we all went out for a drink somewhere with some friends of hers, and at about 1 o'clock or something, I was blind drunk, and we were in the Bourbon and Beefsteak, as it was called at the time, and I decided it was time to go home, and I dropped off at her hotel, which was just around the corner. Can't even remember the name of the place. It's opposite the Kirkton. Sorry, next to the Kirkton. And I was walking home, and I was staggering down William Street and was smashed. And I got about as far as about halfway down, and I thought, oh, I need to get another drink. It's starting to rain. I can't get a cab. So I walked into a bar and was there for a while and having a drink and was getting on fine with the locals, chatting to some of the guys at the bar. And then I realised there were no women in there, and I thought, where am I? And someone, this is the midnight shift. And I went, oh, that's a nice place. And then thought, oh, I wasn't particularly worried by that because I've come from Adelaide, but I staggered out into the night and kept on going down the road, and I was walking down further down William Street, and I saw a prostitute there, and she said, hey, come over here, and I said, it's alright, okay, I'm alright, be okay. I said, no, seriously, come over here. So she took me over to a side area of William Street, in between where they have, like, I always thought it was kind of cool that prostitutes would hang out next to a place that said, Hertz. But anyway, so she pulled me in there, and she made me sit down, and she went over to the Salvation Army caravan thing, got me a cup of coffee and a donut, and said, you're drunk, you're going to get mugged, you've got to sit down, you just can't stagger around like this. And she sat down, gave me the coffee, and made me eat the donut, and she would go off, and she kept talking to people, and trying to find people, looking for a girl for the night. And eventually, she would come back and check up on me, and eventually I was a bit more sober about an hour later, and she said, now, do you have enough money for a cab? Yes, I've got money, I'm living in Glebe, I've got to go. And she said, all right. She went out to the footpath, she hailed a cab, made it pull over, she got me up, made me check that I had enough money, put me in the cab, and sent me off. And that was the first time I thought, King's Cross isn't that bad. You hear about the scary bars, and they're just friendly. You hear about the prostitutes all over the place, and this woman's just put me in a cab and sent me home. I could live around there.